Kyle from WeTechCareOfYou, and today I'm going to look at doing a calculated column in a SharePoint list to predict a date, which is a couple of days into the future, but we're going to do it by weekdays. So this is business days only, it'll ignore the weekend dates, and that's what we're going to do in this video. So a couple of months ago, I uploaded a video where we calculated the date from another date, excluding the weekdays, and then I got several comments on that channel to see if we can do it by business days. So that's what we're going to do in this video. So what I've got up here is the weekday function with the Microsoft ticket. So as you can see, this is just some information about the weekday function which we're going to use in this calculated column. If I just pull up my little notepad here, so as you can see here, in the weekday it returns the number of that day. So, you know, if it returns 1, it's a Sunday, it returns 2, it's a Monday. And as you can see, it keeps going in that order. Now, this is what we're going to use to calculate these days so that whenever it falls on a weekend, it skips those days. And again, you'll see in the video that we can calculate those dates from the day. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to create a date column here. I'm going to call it create a date. So create a date 1. So then if I just quickly populate this, so I'll put the create a date, so we can start with last week. So I'll do this as the Monday. I'll just call this Monday. Another one, Tuesday. Please bear with me. Apologies for all of this messing. So Thursday, Friday. Final 2. Saturday. And Sunday. Okay, so now you can see we've got a date for each showing and the selector for each day of the week. So what we're going to do now is we're going to create a calculated column, and for this example I'm just going to do it where it predicts the date 2 days after this in working days format. So I'm going to call this follow-up date. We'll set it to auto calculate 2 days in advance from these, but obviously when it gets to Friday, instead of calculating to the Sunday, it'll calculate to Tuesday, so it'll skip out those weekends. So I'm just going to create a new column here. If I just go to more, that'll let me do the calculated column. So follow update by 2 days. Okay, and then here's the formula here. So okay, so I'm just going to show you my notepad again. So this is the formula I'm going to put in. So I've written this formula here. So basically, you know, I've made this as sort of easy to read as possible. But basically what this does is it checks the date. So it says if, and then it runs this function. So the weekday of this date, if that equals 1, i.e. going back to our thing. So if that equals Sunday, then we want to take that date and we want to just plus 2 days of that. So as you can see, this runs through each one. So it starts with Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, and it's just going to add 2 for the majority of them. But as you can see here, when we get down to Thursday, it's going to plus 4 because it wants to skip those 2 weekend days. Else when it gets to Friday, it does the same thing. And then when it's on the Saturday, it just pluses the 3 because it's already skipping one of those days. So I hope that makes sense. So this is just for 2 days. So now what I'm going to do, I'm just going to put this formula into the formula in SharePoint. I want to set this as a date and time here for the formula that's returned. And now when I click OK, that should work. So there we can see, so we've got the Monday, so that shows up as the Wednesday, Tuesday plus, so that's just plus and 2 days for each of them there. Then as you can see, it get to the Thursday. So let me just see here. So when we get to the Thursday the 3rd, we want to plus 2 days for that, so that's 1, and then two, so it goes straight to the 7th, so there you can see it skipped out that weekend. Friday goes to the 8th, and then Saturday, Sunday all go to the 8th, because again, it skips out those days. So I hope this video helps. What I'll do is I will put the formula to that in the description for the 2 days. Obviously, I know a lot of these examples, you might want it to be 7 days or, you know, a month. I'm hoping that you can figure that out by the formula that I've showed you. If not, please just add a comment into the YouTube channel. You know, I'm happy to sort of rewrite that formula if it can help anyone out. But I hope this video helps, and please like and subscribe to the channel, and take care. Thank you.